Hello everyone, I am Divya, your math facilitator. In this session, we shall solve the problems of exercise 1.1 of real numbers chapter. So, few problems of this exercise I have already solved in the earlier video. If you are missed watching it, then I'll pin up in the I button. So, you can click on the I button and watch those videos. And also watch the concept video so that you'll have a clear understanding about the concepts to do the problems. Now, let's get started. So in this question, you have to express these rational numbers as decimals, okay? So here in the first bit, you have 242 divided by 1000. So whenever you have multiples of 10 here in the denominator, you can directly, you know, convert it into decimals without even dividing it, okay? So you learned it in your lower classes. How? So you'll write the numerator as it is, 242, okay? Now how many zeros are there in the denominator? 1, 2, 3. So you'll count three places from the right, okay? So 1, 2, 3, and you'll put a decimal point, okay? Now before the decimal point, you don't have any number, so you can write 0, okay? So 0.242 is a decimal, okay? So converting this rational number, you'll get 0.242. clear? Next is 354 divided by 500. Look at the denominator, you don't have 10, 100,000, etc. So you have 500. So you have to divide it. So how will you divide it? 354 divided by 500. Okay, you can bring this to lowest form and then divide, or else you can directly divide also, because it is 5 table. You can divide this by 5 table. It will be easy for you. Okay, so see here you have 354. Okay, so 354 is smaller than 500. So you have to take a 0. When you are taking 0, you will write a decimal point. Okay, now this is 3540. You know that 5 sevens are 35. Okay, 5 sevens are 35. Isn't it? Now what about 500 sevens are? Okay, so you will write the same 35, and here you have two zeros, so you'll write those two zeros here. Understood? So see, so this goes 7 times, you have 3500. Okay, now subtracting, you get 40. Okay, so already you took a decimal point, so you can take a zero directly. Okay, so now see, now also you cannot divide it. 400 is less than 500. So write a 0 here and you can take a 0 again. Okay, so this is 4000 and this is 500. You know that 5 eights is what? It is 40. Okay, so what about 500 eights? You'll write two more zeros here. Understood? So 500 eights are 4000. So let us take 8, 4000. Okay, so 354 by 500, you can express it as 0.708. Now the next one, you have 2 divided by 5. Okay, so 2 divided by 5. 2 is a smaller number, so you write a decimal point. Okay, now 5 fours are 20. Understood? So this is nothing but 0.4. Very simple, right? Next you have 115 divided by 4. Okay, so see, 4 twos are 8. Okay, so subtracting, what do you have? 3 is a remainder and you can bring this 5 down. Okay, now 4 eights are 32. Again, 3 is a remainder. Now 3 is not divisible by 4, so you take a decimal point and you can write 0. Okay, 4 sevens are 28. So 2 is a remainder. Already you took a decimal point, so you can write 0. 4 fives are 20. Okay, so 0. Remainder is 0. That means this you can express it as 28.75. So moving on to the next bit of this question, okay, sixth, second Roman, first bit. Okay, so you have to divide 2 by 3. Okay, so 2 is a smaller number than 3, so take a decimal point, you can write 0. Okay, so 3 sixes are 18. Okay, again 2 is a remainder, you have already taken a decimal point, so you can take 0. 3 sixes are 18 again. Now again 2 is a remainder, you can take a decimal, you have a decimal point, so you can take 0. So 3 6 are 18 again. Again you got a remainder 2. Okay, which means if you divide, if you continue dividing also, 2 will be the remainder always. Okay, and here in the question you can see 6 is repeating. Okay, so this you have learned that you can express this as 0.666, so on, you can express it as 0.6 bar. Why? Because 6 is repeating, you can write a bar over 6, which means this 6 is repeating. Clear? And it is not ending. What type of decimals are these, by the way? they are non-terminating decimal. There is no end to it. Okay, in the previous bit you have learned that they are terminating decimal. There was an end to it. The decimal came to an end, okay, somewhere. It was not continuing, but here you can see it is continuing, isn't it? So that's the difference. Now let us move on to the next one. You have 25 divided by 36, you have minus 25. Don't get confused with the sign, okay? Minus sign, you can keep it at the end, okay? For the answer, you can keep a minus sign. The division, you can do it, okay, in the same process. So 36 and 25. 25 is a bigger number than 36, so you have to take a decimal point. Now it is 250, okay? So 36 sevens will give you 252, okay? So let us take 36 sixes. So sixes gives you 216, okay? So subtracting, what do you get? So it is nothing but 4. This is 3, okay? 34. Okay, so if you take a 0 here again, because 34 is less than 36, so see, you have 324. 36 nines is 324. Okay, again subtracting, see, this is 6, this is 1, you have 16. So let us take 36 threes up, it is 18, 108. 36 fives up will give you 30. 15, this is 180. Okay, so let us say 36 fours are, so this is 24, 12, 14. Okay, so let us take fours are, let us take this as 160, so it is 144. Okay, so subtracting, what do you have? This is nothing but 6 and this is 1, 16. Okay, so again we can take a 0, okay, again you will get 4, so this becomes 144. Subtracting, again you will have 16, you can take 0, again you will have 4 in the quotient, okay, so you will get again 16. So this means the 16 remainder is repeating and this 4 quotient is repeating. So this you can express it as minus, you have a minus sign, so I am writing minus 0.69. See, 4 is repeating, 69 is not repeating, only 4 is repeating. So you will write a bar on 4, okay, not on 69, only on 4 you will write a bar, because only 4 is repeating. Clear? Now let us take the next one. 7, 22 divided by 7. Okay, so 7 threes are 21, so 1 is a remainder, so it is not divisible, so let us take a decimal point, write 0. 7 ones are 7, 3 is a remainder, okay, so you can take a decimal point. 7 fours are 28, so 2 is a remainder, so you can take a 0. 7 twos are 14, 6 is a remainder, you can take a 0. 7 eights are 56, okay, so 4 is a remainder, okay, so you can take a 0 again. 7 fives are 35, so 5 is a remainder, okay, so again you can take a 0, okay, so then you'll have again. 7 sevens are 49, okay, so 1 is a remainder, again you can take a 0. So 7 ones are 7, 3 is a reminder, you can take a 0. 7 fours are 28, okay, 2 is a reminder, you can take 0. 7 twos are 14, 6 is a reminder. So you see, first you got 10, 30, 20, 60, 40, 50. Again you got 10, 30, 20, again 6, 6 means you can write it as 60 and divide. That means there are, this is again repeating, from here it is repeating the same steps, isn't it? So see here, you have 22 by 7 as 3.14285. again this 142 is repeating, okay, that means this entire thing is repeating. So this you can write as 3.14285 with a bar over it, okay? Why? Because all these digits are again repeating. Clear? So I went little cross, so let me erase this, okay? Take down this answer, I'll erase the board now. So the next one is 11 divided by 9, okay? So 9 ones are 9, so 2 is a remainder, you can take a decimal point. Again you have 11 twos are 18, 2 is a reminder, you can take a 0. 2s are 18, 2 is a reminder. So this 2 is repeating and here also 2 is repeating in the quotient. So this you can write as 1.222 and so on, which is nothing but 1.2 bar. Why? 2 is repeating, so you can write a bar over it. Next question is, you have to express these decimals in rational form. Okay, so it is very simple, just see. So this you will write it as whatever you have. Okay, the number you will write it as the same, 036. Okay, divided by, rational is nothing but P by Q form. Okay, so this is P divided by, now you will write 1 Okay, you'll write 1 and you'll count how many decimal places are there. See here, after decimal point, how many places are there? 1, 2. Okay, so you'll write 2 zeros. Clear? Now see, this 0 before the number is meaningless. Okay, it will not change the value. So you'll just simply erase the 0. Okay, for your understanding, I have taken it. So directly you can write as 36/100. Clear? Let us see the next one. You have 154. Okay, I'm just ignoring the decimal. It is 154. Divided by, you'll write 1. Along with how many zeros? After decimal, how many places are there? You have only one place. So you'll write only 10. Clear? Next one. 10.25, you can write it as 1025 divided by 1. Along with how many zeros? After decimal, how many places are there? 1, 2. So 2 zeros. Right, now this is 325 divided by 1. How many places are there after decimal? 1, 2. So 2 zeros. Moving on to the next bit, you have to express the given decimal number into rational. Okay, but in the previous question, you had a terminating decimal 3.25. That means it is ending. Okay, but here the question is 0.5 bar, which means it is nothing but 0.55555. So that 5 repeats, it is continuing. So which decimal it is? It is non-terminating decimal. Okay, so all these concepts we have discussed very clearly in the concept video. Okay, so if you know the concepts, then understanding the problem and solving it will be really easy. Clear? So let us take whatever is given, the decimal given as x. Okay, so let x is equal to 0.5 bar. Okay, so 0.5 bar is nothing but this 5 is repeating and so on. Okay, let this be equation 1. Clear? So what is the next step? Now we have discussed two concepts there, period and periodicity. What is period? Period is the number which is repeating is period. Which number is repeating here? 5 is repeating. So 5 is a period. What is periodicity? Periodicity is how many numbers are repeating is periodicity. Okay, so how many numbers are repeating? Only one number is repeating. Only this 5 is repeating. Okay, so periodicity is 1. Okay, so how many numbers are repeating? You can see here. Under bar, how many numbers you have? Only one number. So only one number is repeating. Okay, here, what is periodicity? Periodicity is nothing but how many numbers are repeating. How many are repeating? Can you tell me? Only one number is repeating. So periodicity is 1. Okay, therefore, we multiply equation 1 by 10. Okay, because only one number is repeating, you will take 1 along with 10. If two numbers are repeating, you will take 1 along with how many zeros? 2 zeros. Then it will be 100. Okay, so here only one number is repeating, so you will take 1 along with 10. So it is 10. Okay, so multiplying equation 1 by 10, what will you get? You will get 10x. 10 into x is 10x is equal to, so this if you multiply by 10, what happens? This decimal moves one place to the right, isn't it? So you'll have 5.555 and so on. This is nothing but equation 2. Now what you will do, you will subtract equation 1 from equation 2. Okay, so when you subtract equation 1 from 2, what you will have? 10x is equal to 5.555 and so on. Equation 1 is x is equal to 0.555 and so on. Okay, so subtracting, what happens? So this 10x minus x gives you 9x is equal to 5 minus 5 is 0. This is 0. This is 0. 0.5 minus 0 is 5. So you got 9x is equal to 5. Now can you tell me what is x value? X is nothing but 5 divided by 9. Here 9 is in multiplication, going it to other side you will get division. Okay, so x is 5 divided by 9, but what is x? X is nothing but 0.5 bar. You have taken x as 0.5 bar, isn't it? So 0.5 bar is nothing but 5/9. So you have converted a decimal into rational. Now the next question is 3.8 bar. Okay, which means you will take it as x, and x is nothing but 3.8 is repeating, isn't it? So that you will take it as equation 1. Okay, the same steps again. Now how many decimals are repeating? Only one decimal is repeating, so periodicity is 1. So you'll multiply with what? You'll multiply with 1 along with 1 0. Why? Periodicity is 1, so you'll write only 1 0. Okay, so multiplying equation 1, this equation with 10, what will you get? This is 10x is equal to, this decimal will move here. So it is 38.888 and so on. This is nothing but equation 2. Now subtract equation 1 from 2, the same steps repeats, okay? So 10x is equal to 38.888 and so on. X is equal to, what do you have? You have 3.888 and so on. Okay, so subtracting 10x minus x is 9x is equal to 8 minus 8 0, 8 minus 8 0, 8 minus 8 0. 8 minus 3 is 5 and you have 3 here. Okay, so what is the value of x? X is 35 divided by 9. Okay, x is nothing but what? It is 3.8 bar. So this means 3.8 bar, you can write it as 35 divided by 9. The next question is 0.36 bar. Okay. So let us take it as x. Now x is 0.36 bar. Okay, bar is on 3 and 6. That means 3 and 6 are repeating. Okay, so 3, 6, 3, 6 and so on. This is equation 1. Okay, now tell me what is the periodicity? How many numbers are repeating? 2 numbers are repeating. 3 and 6 are repeating. Isn't it? So periodicity is 2. When periodicity is 2, you will multiply equation 1 by 1 along with how many zeros? 2 zeros. Okay, so that means you will multiply it with 100. Okay, so let us multiply. X into 100 is 100x is equal to, so you will multiply by 100, that means how many places you will move, right? 2 places. Okay, so this becomes 36.3636 and so on. This is equation 2. Okay, now you have to subtract equation 1 from 2. So 100x is equal to 36.3636 and so on. So x is equal to 0.3636 and so on. Okay, so subtracting, what do you have? 99x is equal to, okay, so 6 minus 6 is 0, 3 minus 3 is 0, 6 minus 6 is 0, 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay, 6 minus 0 is 6 and this is 3. Okay, so x is equal to 36 divided by 99. Clear? Now you can see, you can cancel it in 9 table. So 9 11s are, 9 4s are. Okay? So x is nothing but 4 by 11. Okay, what is x? X is 0.36 bar. So 0.36 bar, you can write it as 4 by 11. Moving on to next question, you have 3.127 bar. The bar is only on 7. Okay, so it is nothing but 3.12. Only 7 is repeating. The bar is on how many numbers? Only one number. It is only on 7. Okay, so only this 7 will repeat. Understood? Understand the difference. Otherwise, you will make a mistake. Okay, now what is the periodicity? Periodicity is how many numbers are repeating? How many are repeating? Only one number is repeating. Okay, only 7 is repeating. Okay, so you will multiply equation 1 by 1 along with how many zeros? What is the periodicity? 1. So how many zeros you will take? You'll take only 1 0. So this is 10x is equal to, so this will move one place. So it is 31.2777 and so on. This is equation 2. Now I'll subtract both the equations. So 10x equal to 31.2777 and so on. X equal to 3.1277 and so on. Okay, so subtracting 7 minus 7 0, 7 minus 7 0, 7 minus 2 5, 2 minus 1 is 1 point. Now see, you have to borrow. Okay, so this becomes 8, this is 2 equal to 9x. Okay, so you have 9x equal to 28.15. Okay, now see, again you have a decimal point here. Now let us write what is x first. X is equal to 28.15 divided by 9. Okay, 9 I am taking it to this side. Now again you see, you have a decimal point. This is not a rational number. So what do you do? So 28.15, how will you convert it into rational? You have learnt. Okay, 2815 divided by 1 along with how many decimal places are there? 2. So you will write it in this way. Okay, so 28.15 you can write it in this way. So let us write 2815 divided by 100 and you have one more 9 here in the denominator. Okay, so this is nothing but 2815 divided by 900. Okay, you can even reduce it to lower form. You can see both get cancelled in 5 table. So this is nothing but 5 is a 25, 3 is a remainder, 5 6 are 30. So this is 3. Okay, so 5 1s are 5, 4 is a remainder, 5 8s are 0. Okay, so x you can write as 563 by 180. What is x? X is nothing but 3.127 bar. You can write it as 563 by 180. Now moving on to the next question without actually dividing. Now in the sixth question you have divided. The rational number is given to you. You have divided and converted it into decimal. But here without dividing you have converted it into decimal. So this is a concept of your class 10. Okay, so there you'll have a theorem saying that if this denominator, let me say it very briefly for you. So if p by q is a rational number, if this denominator q, if you are able to express it in terms of 2 and 5, okay, so in terms of 2 power m into 5 power n, okay, so then this becomes a terminating decimal. Okay, if you can express it in this way in terms of 2 and 5, it is a terminating. If you find any other number in the denominator other than 2 and 5, then it is non-terminating. Clear? So denominator, if you can write it in the term of 2 and 5, it is terminating. If you find any other number other than 2 and 5, it is non-terminating. Okay, so the question is you have to check if they are terminating or not. Okay, if these decimals are terminating or not. So the same concept we will use. So you will concentrate on what? You will concentrate on the denominator. Okay, here you have 3 by 25. Okay, so 25 you can write as 5 square. What do you have in the denominator? You have 5. Okay, so I told if you have 2 or 5 or 2 and 5, you can have any of these numbers, 2, 5, or you can have both 2 and 5. Then it is what? It is a terminating decimal. Okay, so you write it here. The denominator contains 2 or 5. Okay, so which means it is a terminating decimal. Okay, see the next one, 11 by 18. Okay, 11 by 18 is nothing but 3 sixes. Okay, 6 you can write it again as 2 into 3. Okay, now just see, I told you should have only 2 and 5 in the denominator. But what do you have? You also have 3 in the denominator. So is it terminating? No. So this is non-terminating. Okay, so this is non-terminating. Why? Other than 2, you also have 3. So you should have only 2 and 5, or you can have both 2 and 5, but you should not have any other number. Okay, now see 13 by 20. 13 by 20 is nothing but 4 5s are. Okay, 4 you can write it as 2 square. Now here you have only 2 and 5 in the denominator. So is it terminating? Yes, it is terminating. Okay, now see 41 by 42. 41 by 42 you can write it as 6 7s are 42. Okay, 6 is nothing but 2 3s are, you can write. Okay, see other than 2 you have 3 and 7 also. Okay, there are other numbers. You don't have only 2 and 5, you have 3 and 7, which means is it terminating? No, it is non-terminating. You should have only 2 or 5 or 2 and 5. If you have any other number other than 2 and 5, then it is non-terminating. Very simple, right? So this brings us to the end of this exercise. I hope you learnt all the solutions of this exercise, and you can give me your feedback in the comment section below. And don't forget to like the video, and if you're new to the channel, do subscribe the channel and leave so that you won't miss any interesting stuff on the channel. Thanks for watching.